सम पार्ट ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव ट्रैक्ट. सो लेट अस सी बियॉन्ड दैट. ओके Anyone having any difficulties with the part which we have completed? Please feel free to clear your doubts. Okay. So we had completed this particular slide, if I'm not wrong. It will come. It will come. Hemorrhagism will come. Wait. Yeah, it will come. I'll talk about it. Okay. It's going to be a part of placenta formation ke time pe. This word will come. I'll explain about that particular time. Right. So anyone who is having any difficulty with it, beta, huh? Primary oocyte gets to form Graafian follicle alternatively every month. Yes, my dear. Yes, correct. Alternatively from each ovary. So every month there is going to be one ovulation that is going to take place. That means one Graafian follicle is going to be formed during every month in alternate ovaries, right? Yes, bacha. Fine. So this is what we had seen, that how the Graafian follicle is being formed. And I guess we had seen this diagram as well. And I told you all that don't worry about the diagram later on part. So till here we had seen, if I'm not wrong, till here. Okay. So just have a quick recap about all those things. Okay. So this is going to be the primary oocyte. Not yet released from meiosis one. So it's going to be arrested at diplotene phase of meiosis one. A cell layer is forming around it, which is nothing but it is the cell of the stroma, right? So the stromal cells are forming a layer around it. A follicle consists of a cell layer and the oocyte. So whenever we use the word follicle, what do you mean by the word like secondary follicle? Okay, na? Primary follicle. So what do you mean by that word follicle? Oocyte at the center, surrounded by the cells, stromal cells or follicular cells. So you can see over here, a transparent and somewhat elastic layer called a zona pellucida is going to be forming. And you can see the shape of these follicular cells, which were flat, have become columnar, right? The problem is, you know, it is not, the file is large, so it is not, you know, being sent as anyone can, you know, view it. So I'm just trying to minimize, you know, reduce that size of the file, because even in that male reproductive system also, you told me that there are some slides which are blank, na? So probably because of the size of the file. So I'm just trying to, you know, make it compatible enough so that, you know, it comes in your WhatsApp. So I'm just behind that. So just give me a couple of days, it will be done. Okay, both. I'll resend both, male as well as female. Because of that, some compatibility issue, I think this is going on. They are not available on the YouTube. Huh, like the lectures would be there, of course. So there, from there, you can as of now. That's for sure. Correct. Yeah. Perfect question. Right, my dear. Perfect. Okay. So here is going to be the zona pellucida being formed. And you can see now the layers of the follicular cells is going on increasing. And eventually it is going to form a, you know, a cavity over there. And we know this cavity will be called as what? Antrum. And this antrum will eventually get filled with fluid. So it's a fluid filled cavity starts forming in the follicular cells layer. Now here in this particular diagram, you can very well see that this is going to be the developing secondary, you know, follicle over here. First follicle, meiosis one is over. First polar body, or the can be seen over here, and here is the secondary oocyte. Now, what is going to happen? See, here there is shown as rupturing of this Graafian follicle. So, when the Graafian follicle is going to rupture out, you can very well see that few cells are still attached with this particular secondary oocyte. And these cells are going to be nothing but corona radiata, right? And here there is going to be the first polar body. Now this entire assembly is going to be thrown out from the ovary to reach the infundibulum of the fallopian tube, right? So it's going to roll down now. Let me tell you all, the egg is going to be non-motile. This entire assembly is non-motile, but the fallopian tube is going to have cilia present in them. So the cilia is going to do the sweeping action. So the cilia will sweep in such a direction that the secondary oocyte is going to be pushed ahead. So they are just going to be acting like a broom, the cilia of the fallopian tube, right? They are going to act like a broom. Okay, what will happen then is something that we have to understand. So they are saying ovulation, mature follicle ruptures and releases the secondary oocyte as well as the first polar body. Now, there are two things that might happen as we had discussed the other day. The spermatozoa might reach the ampullary region by the time when the secondary oocyte also reaches there. Or if there's no possibility, then what will happen? So we have to understand the two reasons. But before that, just see this diagram, which will clear your doubts. This was your primary oocyte, correct? Formed from the primordial cell of the cuboidal epithelium, germinal epithelium. Hai na? So see, these are the ones which are growing and few of them now got converted into your, you can see this, zona pellucida. This is one row of the follicular cells. You can see this, right? At this stage, what are they saying? See, at birth, no further development until sexual maturity. So this particular stage, the girl child will be born. Okay. Now see, the primordial follicles containing primary oocytes. Like this, it's going to be. Early primary follicle, secondary follicle. Now here is the time when they are saying first meiotic division completed. Means this is going to be when follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone secreted at sexual maturity, only then this will move on to this stage. Okay, till that time ye stage nahi aayega, early primary follicle stage tab tak nahi aayega beta jab tak FSH LH secrete nahi hote hai. So from the birth till the sexual maturity, whatever number of years is going to take, some females start with their menarche at the age of 10, 11, some 12, 13, 14, 15 also sometimes. So till that particular time, the female will have these structures, that is these primordial follicles containing primary oocytes and the follicular cells surrounding it. This structure will be maintained. After the secretion of FSH and LH, then it will become early primary follicle, secondary follicle. You can see this, how it is happening now. First meiotic division is getting completed after the secondary follicle. Then they are saying, see, secondary follicle containing secondary oocyte, of course, along with the polar body. So here is the ovulation. You can see this. Here, ovulation is taking place along with the polar body. Again, they are showing these corpus luteum and corpus albicans. What is that? Is what I'm going to talk about right now. But till here, is there any difficulty in understanding that at what time of the female age the first meiotic division gets arrested? When will the meiosis one resume? Any difficulty in understanding these things? But these are basic, but these are very important. Anyone who have not understood any point regarding this? All okay? Idhar tak sabko samjha hai? I know it's a part of revision that we have done in the earlier class, but still. Good, my dears. Good. Well, see, now they are saying after 13 days of the menstrual cycle, that's going to be on the 14th day when the cell is ideally of 28 days. So the cycle now is actually going to be ideally of 28 days. How? I'll explain. Okay. What's your doubt, beta? Primary follicle is the membrana granulosa. Yes, yes, yes. Perfect, perfect. Membrana granulosa. Very correct. Very correct. So how is the 28 days of menstrual cycle? I'll explain along with the days, what happens during a particular day. I'll explain that, but still after ovulation, that is going to be on the 14th day. So see, generally when the menstrual cycle is going to be of 28 days, 28 ka midpoint aata hai 14, exactly half of 28 would be 14. So on the 14th day, ideally, again, I'm using the word ideally, it's not always that's going to happen. Huh? I'm just saying ideally, on the 14th day, this Graafian follicle ka doom hona chahiye. Ideally, Graafian follicle burst hona chahiye for the liberation of the secondary oocyte. Okay, so that is they are saying that after 13th day of the menstrual cycle, that is going to be on the 14th day, the Graafian follicle is going to rupture and the egg, that means the secondary oocyte along with the first polar body will be thrown out into the fallopian tube. Agreed? So after ovulation, what will happen? See, after ovulation, the ruptured Graafian follicle would be now called as corpus luteum. But what happens is, you know, yeah, it's called as corpus luteum, but how is that corpus luteum going to be formed? So see, soon after ovulation, my dear, ovulation ka matlab itna hi samajh lena ki secondary oocyte Graafian follicle ko tod ke bahar aa raha hai. Huh? So after ovulation, the remaining granulosa cells, that is your membrana granulosa cells of the Graafian follicle, proliferate. Proliferate means they increase in number. So even after the liberation of the secondary oocyte, they are now going to again come together. They are going to regenerate and they are going to increase their number of cells. Right? So they are going to proliferate and these cells look yellow in color due to the accumulation of the pigment called as lutein. Hence, now the structure is called as corpus luteum. Luteum, kyu naam pada usko? So luteus ka matlab hota hai, lutein ka matlab hota hai, yellow in color. So because it is going to be yellow in color, this particular structure will be now called as corpus luteum. So if you can see over here, see this one, this diagram. Ye dekho. This particular thing, can you see? How it is again undergoing proliferation? It has, you know, wo toot gaya, lekin wo bikhar nahi gaya. Tootne ke baad wo wapis samet gaya. Wo wapis ek saath aa gaya. They have come together. All the cells have again come together and they have formed this bulbous structure. Look at it. It's such a huge structure which is going to be called as corpus luteum. So corpus luteum forms from the remnants of the ruptured follicle. Okay. So you can see this is corpus luteum. Now what is so important about corpus luteum? See, before ovulation, the follicle was vascular, means it had blood supply. But soon after ovulation, blood vessels grow and corpus luteum becomes filled with blood. Oh my God, just imagine that this particular gland over here, see, you can see over here, these are the blood vessels, right? So till here now, it was going to get the, this is not going to be vascular, but once it becomes like this way, you can see this. Can you see this blood clot, early corpus luteum, mature corpus luteum, ye dikhai de raha hai aapko. So yahan par blood clot dikhai diya. Blood clot dikhai diya ka matlab kya hai? Definitely, it is going to be filled with blood. How will it get filled with blood? By the vascular entry of the blood vessels. So before ovulation, the follicle was avascular, right? Graafian follicle ke andar blood vessel wagera kuch nahi tha, huh? So it was avascular. But soon after ovulation, blood vessels grow and corpus luteum becomes filled with blood. Central part filled with blood is called as corpus hemorrhagicum. Did you get the answer? Someone was asking me, what is hemorrhagicum? You understood what is hemorrhagicum now? Oh no, someone asked me in the beginning only. Na? I think someone asked me about hemorrhagicum only. Huh, you got your answer, beta? So this blood clot region that you're going to see in the corpus luteum is nothing but now we call it as corpus hemorrhagicum. Okay? Yeah, beta. Yeah. So lutein cells or corpus lutein. Now, start synthesis of progesterone hormone. So see, my dears, we know that female reproductive system, jo hai, it is basically associated with production of two major hormones, estrogen and progesterone. So we are already seeing that who makes estrogen. And today we came to know that it is the corpus luteum, which is going to make progesterone hormone. डू यू ऑल रिकलेक्ट ईस्ट्रोजन वॉज मेड बाय हूम? याद है परसों का लेक्चर? विल यू ट्राई आंसरिंग माई क्वेश्चन? एक्सिलेंट सुन, एक्सिलेंट, यस, परफेक्ट. हु इज द वन हु इज गोइंग टू मेक ईस्ट्रोजन? ओनली वन आंसर फ्रॉम जूई. कम ऑन अदर्स, गुड मॉर्निंग. Who's this? Siddhika. Very nice. Perfect answer, my dear. Correct. Only two people are studying. Only two girls are studying in our class, I guess. Zui and Siddhika. Only two girls are studying. Come on, I had told you all that day that this is going to be the layer which is going to produce ovaries. No. No. Not exactly. Even Vaishnavi is studying. Oh my god, no, my dear. Adrenal gland and no. Nowhere associated with adrenal gland. Okay, Vidhi is also studying. Even Vidhi has given me the right answer. Very good, Vidhi. Yes. But don't give me as a question mark. You're right, and you have given the right answer. So very good. Ruby has also given the right answer. I don't know why you all are putting a question mark over there. You all are perfectly right with your answers, my dear. Who is this? Shachi has also given the right answer. Divya, correct. Okay. So now I feel like, you all are, do girls ke alawa, baki ke bhi girls hai jo pad rahe hai. Haan, iska matlab boys nahi pad rahe na. Sirf girls pad rahe na. Yes, Palak, right. Correct answer. So till now, whatever answers have come now have come from girls. Come on, boys. Come on. Wake up and tell me the answers quickly. Chalo batao. At least one of the boys should answer this question. Come on. Then you will again. Again, then you will say. Come on. I want all of you all to get involved. Very good. Yes, Medanshu, you are right, my dear. Bhumi, it's right. Yes, Shwe. Tika interna. Okay. So you know that day we saw that Tika interna, I told you that they are nothing but the cell aggregates of the other stromal cells which will form a layer over the developing follicle. And that is going to be synthesizing the estrogen. So who synthesizes estrogen? So estrogen is going to be synthesized by the theca interna. And who is going to produce the progesterone? Progesterone is going to be produced by corpus luteum. Is it fine? Ab dimag mein fit ho gaye dono naam. Theca interna estrogen banata hai. And progesterone banane wala hai apna corpus luteum. In mein se agar dekhoge, toh this is going to be your matured corpus luteum. Is it okay? So see, my dear, it becomes an endocrine gland. Hai na? Ye gland ban jata hai. It's going to secrete a hormone. So hormones are secreted by glands, my dears. So definitely this is going to be what? A gland. So corpus luteum now becomes or gets converted into an endocrine gland who is going to synthesize hormone. Okay. Both are for the endometrium and even, we'll see if there is going to be fertilization, what is the role of this corpus luteum and all. We'll see. Okay. Fine. Now, besides this corpus luteum, they have given this small white color ka scar, which is going to be called as corpus albicans. What is corpus albicans? Of course, I'll tell you. But before I move ahead with corpus albicans, any difficulty with this particular slide that we are talking about? Anyone who has not understood anything about this particular content? Okay, I'll go ahead. Fine. Yeah, see, now there are the possibilities. If fertilization occurs in fallopian tube, the corpus luteum then becomes stable for 9 months. So this corpus luteum would be maintained for that all gestational period time, that is for all the 9 months of the pregnancy, this corpus luteum would be maintained. It won't, it will remain stable. It won't get degenerated, right? Yeah, what's your doubt, beta? Fecal interna secretes estrogen and corpus luteum secretes progesterone. Huh? Correct. Yes. Perfect. Perfect. Very true. So if the fertilization is going to take place, then what's going to happen? This corpus luteum, jo hai na, apna yellow color ka jo bulbous aise bana hua tha, it's going to remain intact. Don't you think if it's going to remain intact for all the 9 months, it has got the same function, that is to keep on producing progesterone? What was the function of corpus luteum? To produce progesterone. Agreed. Now it is going to be present for all the 9 months. Don't you think the progesterone has to be, you know, it's going to be produced for the entire gestational period, and therefore now corpus luteum is also called as your gestational structure, and progesterone as your gestational hormone ya pregnancy hormone kehte usko. Okay. Yes my dear, bilkul correct. Yes my dear, you're right with your you know content. Yes. So, if fertilization occurs in the fallopian tube, the corpus luteum then becomes stable for 9 months. Progesterone hormone maintains pregnancy and repairs the wall of uterus to make its surface adhesive to help in implantation. So, what's going to happen is, for all the 9 months, this particular endometrium wall has to be maintained. It has, because it's going to be that particular wall inside which the embryo development is taking place, right? So the endometrium should not get shed off. It should not get scraped off. It should not get damaged. So to keep the endometrium healthy, you know what is endometrium? Endometrium is the innermost lining of the your womb, as we call it. Right? So we have to keep that layer intact. So to maintain that layer intact, what is required? Progesterone is required. And who is going to be secreting progesterone? Corpus luteum. So for all the 9 months, the corpus luteum should go on and on and on synthesizing the progesterone hormone for any repair of the endometrium, any damage to the endometrium. It will immediately come and get it repaired. And secondly, it is going to be, you know, it's going to create surface adhesiveness for implantation. So that morula, that 16 cell structure, which is going to be a product of fertilization eventually, is needed to get, you know, it has to stick to the endometrium. I told you it's going to stick in the fundus region. So it has to stick now. So to stick, it requires some adhering property, some adhesive properties. So that would also be imparted by progesterone. Okay, right? For how much long secondary oocyte waits for the spermatozoa? I'll tell you, very little time. Natak bahut hai, dekho itni natak hai, aage bhi ye natak continued hai. Okay, see, if fertilization does not occur, so if fertilization occurs, then these are the things that the corpus luteum is going to undergo. If fertilization does not occur, then the corpus luteum starts degenerating after about 9 days of its formation. So 14 plus 9 karoge to apna answer aega 23, correct? So on the 23rd day of the menstrual cycle, generally this corpus luteum will start degenerating. So it waits for 9 days. Let the egg get fertilized. Let the egg get fertilized. Let us see if the fertilization is taking place. The progesterone hormone secretion will be continued for the next 9 days. But the life of the secondary oocyte is in 9 days. Huh? Okay. So here it waits. And after 9 days now, it knows that it's of no use. So it will start degenerating. So the degeneration is completed in 14 days. To form corpus albicans. 14 days means not 9 plus 14. 14 days means from the date of ovulation, hame 14 days count karne hai. So practically after 9 days, matlab 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. पांच दिन के बाद इट गेट्स कंप्लीटली कन्वर्टेड इनटू अ वाइट स्टार व्हिच इज कॉल्ड अ कॉर्पसल वाइटेंस. फाइन, सो द रीजनरेशन इज कंप्लीटेड इन 14 डेज टू फॉर्म कॉर्पसल वाइटेंस व्हिच ग्रेजुअली डिसअपीयर्स. कॉर्पसल वाइटेंस अपीयर्स लाइक वाइट स्टार एंड लुक्स लाइक अ रिंकल्ड स्टार. या इट इज डिस्चार्ज अलॉन्ग विद द मेंस्ट्रुअल फ्लो. इट्स सो स्मॉल दैट वी डोंट इवन रियलाइज दैट when it's going to be, you know, like thrown out of the body. No, there was some issue with my net connection. I lost my net connection. Yeah. Don't worry. It was from my end. Nothing. Okay. So the degeneration is for 5 days. Yes. Correct. Okay. So I hope it's going to be stable now. So we were with the fate of the follicles. We had to go ahead with the fate of the follicles. You want me to explain what? See, what are they saying? But here in this particular sentence, they are saying that it takes 14 days for the formation of, to complete the formation of corpuscle vitae. So this 14 days, Joanna, what is those 14 days actually? That is going to be from the date of ovulation. So after ovulation, next 14 days make corpuscle vitae create ho jata hai. So it is not after 9 days of corpus luteum uske baad 14 days of corpuscle vitae, aisa nahi hai. In total, so 14 plus 9 becomes 23rd day the corpuscle vitae is going to corpus luteum is going to start degenerating, and from that 9 days plus 5 days will become 14 days. So from the date of ovulation plus 14 days will be the corpuscle vitae formation. Got it? Understood? Any difficulty, my dear? Aap samjha? 23 days kaisa hai? 14th day of ovulation plus 9 days it will wait na? That is the fertilization occurring. So 14 plus 9 will make up 23 days. So, it will wait for the 23 day तक वो वेट करेगा और उसके बाद वो डीजनरेट होने को स्टार्ट करेगा. ओके ना? फाइन. सो इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड प्लीज आस्क. ना दैट्स अ वेरी गुड हैबिट. आई विल ऑलवेज अप्रिशिएट इफ यू आस्क मी डाउट्स व्हेन नॉट अंडरस्टूड, बिकॉज इट विल पाइल अप, इट विल मेक यू क्रेजी एट द एंड ऑफ द day or at the end of the chapter, na, you will feel, oh my God, I have not understood so many things. So, aise nahi hona chahiye. Poocho, bindas poocho. No issues. Okay. So, let us go ahead with the fate of follicles. Let's see how the fate of follicles has been there in you and me. Okay. The total number of follicles in the two ovaries of a normal young woman is about 4 lakhs. How much it is? It's about 4 lakhs. However, most of them undergo regression and disappearance due to death and are disposed of by phagocytosis during the reproductive years of the females. This is termed as follicular atresia. A very important word with that. Death of follicles is called as follicular atresia. regression means they are going to get diminished, they are going to get degenerated, going back. Okay, that is called as regression. Fine. Okay, this is responsible for limited number of the gamete production in the females. So there are 4 lakh follicles present, but most of them are going to undergo degeneration, disappearance, death. Okay, generally only one ovum is liberated in each menstrual cycle by alternate ovaries. So this, so we already know that alternate ovaries, there's going to be the ovulation will take place. Only about 450 ova are produced by human female over the entire span of a reproductive life, which will last for about 40 to 50 years of her age. So that is why reproductive means capacity to develop these eggs, or capacity to have children. That is called as reproductive age. So from menarch to menopause is going to be the reproductive age. Fine. So here what will happen? What is the reproductive age on an average of a female? It's going to be up till the age of maximum 50. Now, again, as I say, my dears, everyone, individual's makeup is different, and some might, have their menopause as early as the age of 30, 32 also, which very recently, some cases have sprung up. There are few patients, ladies who have approached, and they are complaining about, this menopausal type of symptoms. So nowadays, because of our lifestyle is so bad. Kabhi bhi uthne ka, kabhi bhi sone ka, raat ko late tak jagne ka, kuch bhi kachra khane ka. Abhi to lockdown hai, isliye I hope you all are not eating something outside. But earlier, before this COVID and all, I don't know, kitna bahar ka junk khate the sab log. Hai na? So that is a very bad lifestyle. In fact, it is said to have a good health, we should actually eat breakfast like a king. Do you know this? Lunch like a common man, and dinner should be like a beggar. If you eat like this way, only then you're going to have your good health. But Mumbai mein, it is exactly ulta. Our breakfast is like a beggar. Kuch mila to mila, nahi mila to jaane do. Lunch, kuch to kha lena hai fatafat se. Raat ki baat, haan, raat mein, dinner mein dekho, jo hai, wo mast jo banega, wo dinner mein hi banega. Agreed na? This is a fact. This is a fact. So that is the main reason. That is the root cause for our, bad health or ill health or whatever. Okay, bad health or ill health doesn't mean that you're falling sick. Bad health or ill health means mental, social, behavioral, and physical. It includes all different types of health. Health does not just mean physical health. So it includes all these. Okay, these are going to be all these particular things included. Right? So if because of that, nowadays individuals, menarche and the menopause ke jo years hai, they drift out. But on and on, generally, if you see, menarche is somewhere around the age of 10, 11, 12, and menopause is somewhere around the year of 45 to 48. Okay? And the time period from menarche to menopause will be called as reproductive years. Reproductive years means the capacity of that female to have children. Right? Got it? Okay. So now they are saying in those 32 to 35 years of our reproductive age, approximately. So if we consider that a female has her menarche at the age of 40, at the age of 12, you can, actually around 32 years is going to be the reproductive age. Yes, correct. So here, my dear, we have to calculate. We ourselves can calculate our reproductive age. We know what is our menarche day, here. At what age did we start the menstrual cycle? Correct? you have to add approximately 32 to it. So 12 plus 32 makes up 44. So approximately a female who has started her menstrual cycle at the age of 12 would have menopause somewhere around the age of 44. Okay, so this reproductive age is approximately 32 years. Okay, female dies after the reproductive. No, humans, the entire this is hormonal balance is only different, huh? Human beings are going to have different hormones and a different set of chemical reactions taking place. Okay, well, so this is the way you can calculate, the individual's approximate menopause time. Well, so during these 32 years, around 450 ova are going to be developed. Although most of the follicular cells and the oocytes undergo degeneration during the follicular atresia, some fecal cells formed from the stroma and located around the follicle persists and becomes active. These cells are called as interstitial cells, and these cells secrete small amount of androgens. So what happens is, you know what are androgens? Androgens are actually male hormones, correct? But yes, every female is going to have, little amount of the male hormones in them. And who makes them? The fecal cells make them. Fecal cells means the stroma cells. The stroma cells are going to produce certain androgens also. So some, females have got, hairline, like a mustache-like line on their lips, right? Sometimes it's very, light. You won't realize also. But sometimes it is shown off as a mustache because of the formation of the androgen. So probably in those females, the androgen ka percentage is going to be more as compared to a normal female. So even like some females develop beard also. Yeah, like you've seen? Have you seen females having a little bit of beard also? Huh. So there is nothing wrong in them. The only thing is what? The synthesis of the androgen by the fecal cells in them is a little bit excessive as compared to the normal female. Okay? Okay. So that is the reason like some females even have got a voice much similar to the males. Correct? Mustache-like hairline. They have even a lot of, body hair is also going to be, body hair is also going to be too much on their, skin and all. It's not useful to human body as such, but yeah, to give a little bit of, coarseness and hoarseness, yes, it is. Fine. More levels of testosterone. Yes, Medansha, right, Maria. It's more levels of testosterone. Correct. So a little bit of testosterone is also going to be produced in females as well. Fine. If fertilization of oocytes takes place around menopause, the child will be normal or abnormal because the oocytes are old. Yeah, actually, there is going to be certain abnormality seen in females who are going to have, delayed children. So there are many females now who are career oriented. They don't want to have children in their actual time when they should have at the age. And they delay the, onset of pregnancies by different methods. And then there's going to be an age where all these, see, you have seen just now only that these follicles are undergoing death. They are getting degenerated because they are not going to be that efficient as we age. So the more is the age, more is the difficulty in having, a balanced, normal delivery. So the baby's health sometimes is going to be at stake if the female is pretty old. So generally it's considered that, it's better to have children at the right age. Jo bhi hai, ek hai, do hai, whatever it is planned. Fine. So these all things do matter a lot, We can't say it's still 45. So as I said, if a female has started her menstrual cycle at the age of 10, then her menarche would be somewhere around the age of 42. So not necessarily it's always going to be 45. Okay, and it's not necessary that it's always going to be 32 also. It could be less than 32, it could be more than 32. It depends on the individual's capacity. Okay, yeah. So you understood that why there are, these androgens going to be present and how are they going to get, how is it affecting the females, right? So how many eggs are going to be produced? How many menstrual cycles are going to be experienced by a female in her reproductive age is something that we have to now understand. That's nothing but the menstrual cycle. This is exhibited by the primate group of animals. So we all are primates. In this cycle, the female body prepares itself for a possible pregnancy. So what is the main reason for undergoing menstrual cycle? It's the nature who has gifted a female to become a mother because of this particular cycle. If the pregnancy does not occur, then the body aborts all preparations done and restarts the preparation for pregnancy again in a monthly cyclic manner. So it's, like har nahi manta hai wo. Every month hai na, wo har nahi manta hai. Theek hai, ye month mein maine jo kaam kiya, kaam mein nahi aaya. It's okay. I'll throw this off. I'll make a new one. So this is how there's a consistency that is going to be maintained in, making and breaking and making the endometrial wall especially. This entire cycle is going to be called as menstrual cycle or menstruation. Okay? Menstrual cycle has three main phases. The first is called as the bleeding phase or menstruation phase. So this is the actual phase when a female will experience the shedding off of the endometrium. That is going to be the bleeding phase. Exactly. Yes, my dear. Second is the proliferative phase, pre-ovulatory phase, follicular phase, or estrogenous phase. Now, what do you mean by proliferative? Proliferative means to increase. Pre-ovulatory, before ovulation, so pre-ovulatory. Follicular phase, because here the Graafian follicle formation is going to be started. So follicular phase. Estrogenic phase, theca interna is going to be formed, which will start making the estrogen. All these activities will be taking place in the second phase. The third phase is the secretory phase. Post-ovulatory phase, luteal phase, or progesterogenic phase means, as the name says, post-ovulatory, after ovulation. Secretory, just now I told you the progesterone is going to be secreted by the corpus albicans, right? Luteal phase, because it's going to be the one which is going to be undergoing degeneration eventually. Right? Why is it so? I'll tell you. I'll just tell you with the days how it is. See, the first is the bleeding phase. The cycle starts with the bleeding phase in its first 4 to 5 days. Approximately, on an average, a female is going to menstruate for 4 to 5 days. Okay? That doesn't mean that if it is less or it is more, something is a problem. It's okay. As I again say, these all are on an average, 100 females were tested, out of which on an average, say 80% were showing the bleeding phase for around 4 to 5 days. So it's an average that. So doesn't mind if it is lesser or more. Don't get tense. During this bleeding phase, the part of the layer of the endometrium called as decidua gets shed off. So what has happened, the endometrium, a wall habitat, that means it's like a fleshy layer which has been formed internally inside the endometrium, correct? It's a fleshy layer. अब imagine करना, ये layer को scrape off करते हैं. Scrape off समझते हो? आप नारियल कैसे scrape करते हो? वैसे ये पूरी layer scrape होती है. And it gets logged off. And it gets logged off. Don't you think that particular layer has got blood vessels? It has got nerves. It has got lymph. Everything is going to be present. Imagine that when it is going to get slogged off, of course it's going to be painful sometimes. Correct? And it's but natural. Something is getting scraped off internally. It's natural that, you know, there is going to be at least some sort of, you know, because that, you know, just like shriveling, just like cutting inside, it's going to be, you know, actually sliced off. Who does the slicing? Who does the slicing? Is there any hathiyar inside? Koi hathiyar hai andar? Koi knife hai andar? Bilkul. This is all going to be done by hormones. It's hormonal. How? I'll tell you later on. Okay? So see, the cycle may, the bleeding part may, the part of the layer of the endometrium called as decidua gets shed off. Okay? After 4 to 5 days, what happens? Pre-ovulatory or proliferative phase or follicular phase, as we say. After first 4 to 5 days of this phase, this particular phase is going to begin. So after the bleeding phase, pre-ovulatory phase is going to begin. Right? During this phase, due to the release of GnRH, do you remember there was something called as GnRH in male reproductive tract that we had seen? You remember that negative feedback? Ah, very nice, Shwet. Yes, my dear. Hypothalamus. Yes. Correct. Gonadotropin releasing hormone. Correct. Perfect. So even females, in them also, there is going to be this hypothalamus. And hypothalamus is going to secrete what? GnRH. GnRH जाके किसका good morning कराएगा? किसको किसको बोलेगा उठ जा बेटा, उठ के काम पे लग जा. Come on. Males में वो किसका good morning करा रहा था? Very good, Risha. Very nice, my dear. Come on, tell me others. GnRH जाके किसको उठा के आता है? चलो उठ जाओ, काम पे लग जाओ. Hypothalamus से GnRH secrete हुआ. Very nice. Darshnita correct, Vaishnavi correct. Yes, my dears. So, perfect. So, now the GnRH will reach the pituitary gland in females also. Even in males, the same thing was happening. Do you recollect? Hypothalamus was synthesizing GnRH. GnRH was reaching the pituitary gland. The pituitary gland then started to stimulate FSH. Do you remember? Here also, it's going to start secreting FSH. So, FSH is common between males and females, huh? But what is the difference? See, the FSH will be synthesized by the pituitary. So pituitary secretes FSH to stimulate the ovarian follicle development. In case of males, this FSH was going inside the testes and getting bound to the receptors. And via the receptors, the testosterone formation was being, you know, formed. Do you recollect all those events of the male reproductive system? Exactly. So how testosterone was going to be formed over there? Here, androgen binding protein, correct, ABP, inhibin, testosterone, right? All those were going to be formed. Here, the follicle stimulating hormone is going to be responsible for the stimulation of ovarian follicles. Ovarian follicles means the follicles of the ovary. So, ye follicles kab bane hain? Embryonic age mein bane hain. Wo primordial follicle jo humne dekhe the, usse ye primary oocytes bane hain. Ab ye primary oocytes ko Graafian follicle tak banane ka jo kaam hai, uske liye it requires FSH. So, FSH is required for what? For the good morning of those atke pade meiosis 1 ke follicles hai. उनको ग्राफियन फॉलिकल में कन्वर्ट करने तक का काम जो है ये FSH का है, ठीक है? The ovarian follicle now begin to develop, means what will happen? That granulosa layer, membrana granulosa, antrum formation. Then you remember something called as cumulus oophorus, discus proligaris. You have seen that in the last class. So all these entire things to be formed ultimately to make up a mature graafian follicle is going to take place because of this FSH. Got it? Good. In that, its cheeca interna will now start synthesizing large amount, good amount, increasing amount of what? Estrogen. So we already know that cheeca interna is going to synthesize estrogen. But when will it start making estrogen? Only when FSH is going to be produced. When will FSH be produced? Only when GnRH will come and tell the pituitary gland to produce FSH. Understood how the connection is? Okay. So now the graafian follicle formation has begun. Rising level of estrogen. See, just now we saw cheeca interna has started making increasing amount of estrogen. So rising level of estrogen also provides a positive feedback to the hypothalamus. Positive ka matlab hai, aur banao, aur chahiye, usko hum kehte hai positive. Bas ho gaya, ab band kar do, usko hum kehte hai negative. So because the estrogen level is going on rising and rising and rising, it's sending a positive feedback to the hypothalamus. Due to this, the hypothalamus will release more GnRH. ठीक है, जितना ज्यादा GnRH बनेगा उतना ज्यादा pituitary gland FSH बनेगा, जितना ज्यादा FSH बनेगा उतना ज्यादा graafian follicle development होता जाएगा, जितना ज्यादा graafian follicle development होता जाएगा उतना ज्यादा estrogen production भी होता जाएगा. Understood how the things are? हाँ, so see, the GnRH induces the pituitary to release more FSH. The rising FSH levels, what is the effect of it? Just see. Now, the rising FSH level will cause further growth and development of the ovarian follicle to form a graafian follicle. Correct? समझ में आ गया? तो पहला इफेक्ट क्या है बेटा estrogen का? What is the first effect of FSH का? So the first effect of FSH is going to be development of ovarian follicle to graafian follicle. And what is the second effect, which is also very important? Even further release of the estrogen from the cheeca interna of this developing follicle is the second effect. So more FSH is going to be formed. More will be the release of estrogen from cheeca interna in the development of the FSH and estrogen. Three hormones ka pura khel chal raha hai. Aur estrogen kya kar raha hai? Aur uksa raha hai hypothalamus ko. Very good, you are doing a good job. Come on, you can do it. Make more GnRH. So बीच बीच में ना वाईफाई कनेक्शन इज ट्रबलिंग. एनीवेज नो प्रॉब्लम, वी आर कमिंग बैक टू इट विद इन फ्यू सेकंड्स. ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन? सो नाउ इन दिस वे, इन दिस वे द ईस्ट्रोजन फॉर्मेशन. या देयर इज समथिंग विद, समटाइम्स इट हैपेंस, इट्स टेक्नोलॉजी. सो समटाइम्स वी हैव टू फेस दिस प्रॉब्लम्स. एनीवेज, so any difficulty in the first phase of the menstrual cycle called as the bleeding phase, and the second phase which is called as the pre-ovulatory or proliferative phase. Anyone who has not understood any part, any point of whatever I have said till now, come on, please go through it, please let me know. no difficulty. All understood? Very nice. Last point, even further, so the rising FSH levels will now cause even further release of estrogen, because more is the FSH, more would be the estrogen production. More would be the estrogen production to form your theca interna in the developing follicle. More would be the feedback given to the hypothalamus. Make more GnRH. Make more GnRH. So here they are saying the rising level of estrogen provides a positive feedback to the hypothalamus. So FSH jitna zyada bana, utna estrogen zyada banega. Jitna estrogen zyada banega, utna positive feedback jata rahega hypothalamus ke paas. Okay. Second phase, second point. During this phase, due to release of some GnRH, that is gonadotropin releasing hormone from the hypothalamus, pituitary gland will get instigated to form FSH, and the FSH will stimulate the formation of the ovarian follicle. That means it will help in making the Graafian follicle. Got it? Understood? So hypothalamus will synthesize GnRH. GnRH will instigate pituitary. Pituitary will make FSH. FSH will help in making ovarian follicle. Also it will help in making more of estrogen. Okay? Clear, beta? Clear, all of you? Can I go ahead? Or is there any still any difficulty in the content? Sure. Okay. But see, as the estrogen level goes on rising, by the end of the 10th day, the extreme levels of estrogen are going to be formed actually, which have by then caused maturation of Graafian follicle. So this particular pre-ovulatory phase started after the bleeding phase. So say by around 5th day of the menstrual cycle, this hypothalamus made GnRH, GnRH stimulated pituitary to make FSH, FSH in turn made the primary follicle to get converted into Graafian follicle, make the theca interna and start developing estrogen. All these activities have taken place within 5 days, because they are saying by the end of the 10th day. Now, whenever we count the days, it's from the first day of the menstrual cycle. Counting will be always from the first day of the menstrual cycle. Please understand this. Okay. So 10th day, when we use the word, it's going to be what? It's nothing but the 10th day from the first day of the menstrual cycle. Okay. Will cause the formation of Graafian follicle. Now, once this is going to be made, see what's going to happen. Now, we'll give a negative feedback to the pituitary. So, the estrogen is controlling the synthesis of your GnRH, right or wrong? Yes, it is also going to help. Yes, aage aayega beta. It will come. Right? So estrogen jab bahut high amount mein ban jayega, highest amount mein ban jayega, tab jaake wo hypothalamus ko negative feedback dega ki bhai bas tak, now it's okay. So now what will happen? It will start giving a negative feedback to the pituitary, causing fall in FSH. So ab GnRH jo hai, jo GnRH hai, wo synthesize ho raha hai, lekin estrogen ne kya kiya? Estrogen gave a negative feedback to whom? Not the hypothalamus, but to the pituitary gland. Do you remember inhibin? Do you recollect inhibin? Inhibin kisko de raha tha beta? Negative feedback kisko de raha tha? Kisko de raha tha? Batao mujhe. Tell me. Inhibin was giving a negative feedback. Excellent. Yes. It was also giving a negative feedback to the pituitary gland. inhibin was giving negative feedback to the pituitary gland and testosterone was giving to pituitary as well as hypothalamus. Do you recollect? वो वाला डायग्राम याद है आपको? हाँ, exactly. So in this way, how inhibin was giving a negative feedback to the pituitary gland, the estrogen is going to give a negative feedback to the pituitary gland and stop the production of FSH. But GnRH तो बन रहा है, तो pituitary को कुछ ना कुछ तो करना पड़ेगा. FSH नहीं बनाना है तो क्या हो गया? कुछ ना कुछ तो बनाना पड़ेगा. तो वो कुछ ना कुछ क्या है बेटा? It is another hormone called as luteinizing hormone, or it's called as LH. So they are saying there is a fall in FSH secretion, but it is also going to cause a rise in LH secretion. Now the LH secretion from the pituitary goes on rising. So अब क्या हो गया? FSH के levels drop हो गए and LH के levels बढ़ने लगे. कब से? From the 10th day, when the estrogen has reached its maximum potential, it will now send a negative feedback to the pituitary, stop the production of FSH. But GnRH is being made, and therefore GnRH is still, telling the pituitary make something. So now the pituitary is going to make luteinizing hormone or LH. Okay. Now the luteinizing hormone secretion from the pituitary goes on rising. The abrupt rise, this abrupt means all of a sudden, not in a systematic way. Okay, this abrupt rise generally between 11th to the 13th day in LH concentration in the blood is called as LH surge. Surge matlab kya? Surge in COVID cases. Aajkal ye bahut aapne suna hoga. A spike. A tremendous increase all of a sudden. Usko hum kehte surge. Okay. So this abrupt rise between the 11th to the 13th day of the menstrual cycle, the LH concentration drastically increases in the blood. And this is called as LH surge. Correct? This LH now causes the Graafian follicle to rupture. So LH hai na, LH. जितना ज्यादा बनेगा ना उतना ही ग्राफाइन फॉलिकल बर्स्ट होगा. सो बलून को बर्स्ट करने के लिए कैसे निडल की जरूरत होती है ना, वैसे ही ग्राफाइन फॉलिकल को बर्स्ट करने के लिए एलएच की जरूरत है. सो एलएच इज एक्टिंग लाइक अ नीडल टू बर्स्ट द बलून ऑफ ग्राफाइन फॉलिकल. अगर ग्राफाइन फॉलिकल नहीं बर्स्ट हुआ तो सेकेंडरी ओसाइट कैसे रिलीज होगा, है ना? तो हमने तो देखा था ग्राफाइन फॉलिकल बर्स्ट हुआ और सेकेंडरी फॉलिकल फेलोपियन ट्यूब में आ रहा है. कैसे आ रहा है, कैसे बर्स्ट हुआ? सो द बर्स्टिंग इज प्योरली बिकॉज ऑफ एलएच सर्ज. व्हाट इज एलएच सर्ज? एन एब्रप्ट इंक्रीज इन द लेवल्स ऑफ ल्यूटिनाइजिंग हार्मोन, बिकॉज फॉलिकल स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन का सिंथेसिस अभी स्लो डाउन हो गया है, बंद नहीं हुआ है, स्लो डाउन हुआ है. करेक्ट ना? अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस, हाउ ब्यूटिफुली योर यू नो नेचर इज मैनेजिंग ऑल ऑफ अस, राइट? सो दिस एलएच नाउ कॉजेस द ग्राफाइन फॉलिकल टू रप्चर आफ्टर पार्शियल कंप्लीशन ऑफ मियोटिक टू. वी नो पार्शियल कंप्लीशन मीन्स अगेन इट इज गोइंग टू बी अरेस्टेड एट मेटाफेज टू, राइट, इन द ओसाइट, एंड दस the secondary oocyte is going to be released along with the first polar body. The release of egg or the secondary oocyte, which occurs generally on the 14th day and is called as ovulation. Now you understood? Samjha abhi? Haan, yes. It's called as ovulation. So, first day of the menstrual cycle to the 14th day of the menstrual cycle, जो भी कुछ हुआ है, हैव यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली हैपेंस ड्यूरिंग दीज 14 डेज? सो फर्स्ट टू फाइव डेज ब्लीडिंग, आफ्टर दैट देयर इज गोइंग टू बी जीएनआरएच सेक्रेशन फ्रॉम द हाइपोथैलेमस व्हिच विल ट्रिगर द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड टू मेक एफएसएच. एफएसएच विल देन ट्रिगर टू थिंग्स. first complete the primordial or the primary oocyte to become a secondary oocyte or the Graafian follicle, and second, it will help in the theca interna to make more estrogen. More would be the estrogen, more would be a positive feedback given to the hypothalamus. Make more GnRH, make more FSH. I'll make more of estrogen then. But on the 10th day of the menstrual cycle, the estrogen levels are highest at the peak. That time, the estrogen will send a negative feedback to the pituitary gland. Enough, no more of making me reduce your speed. But GnRH is still being formed. So the GnRH will trigger the pituitary to make something else, not FSH. So kuch to bana. So that kuch to is nothing but luteinizing hormone or LH. Right? So there's going to be a surge, an abrupt increase in the levels of LH between 11th to 13th day of the menstrual cycle. As the LH concentration reaches maximum, it is going to be responsible for bursting the Graafian follicle and liberating the secondary oocyte. This process of liberating the secondary oocyte generally takes place on the 14th day of the menstrual cycle, and it will be called as ovulation. Is it fine till now? Anyone who has got any difficulties, please tell me, my dears. There's the chat box. Bolo. Understood? Pakka. Chalo, main na fill in the blanks poochti hu aapko. Aap bas blanks ke answers mujhe chat box mein dalte jaiye. Huh? 1 minute activity. Chalega? Can I ask you? Would you fill in the blanks for me? Would you try? Let's go ahead. Sure. First thing, the bleeding phase lasts for approximately dash days. Hey, seven wala kaun hai? Seven nahi hai. Suno. Jo bhi main bol rahi hu, usko suno barabar se, please. Arey 14 nahi baba, main bleeding phase pooch rahi hu. I'm asking you bleeding phase. Yeah, it's approximately 5 days. Perfect. 4 to 5 days. Jisne answer diya hai. 5 days. Jisne answer diya hai. Perfect answer. Second blank. After the bleeding phase, there is going to be synthesis of dash hormone from hypothalamus. What is the name of the hormone? Very good. Excellent. Come on, others quickly answer. Patapat, new hormone that is going to be synthesized by hypothalamus. Very nice. Excellent. So it's going to be what? GnRH. Hey, estrogen nahi re bacha. हाइपोथैलेमस थोड़ी ना ईस्ट्रोजन बनाएगा. हाइपोथैलेमस क्या बनाता है? जीएनआरएच बनाता है. हाँ, ओके. जीएनआरएच विल स्टिम्युलेट द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड टू मेक डैश. वेरी नाइस. परफेक्ट आंसर. जल्दी. ये जल्दी का है, रैपिड राउंड है. ये मुझे फटाफट आंसर्स चाहिए सबके. आई नॉट एस्ट्रोजन. पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड क्या बनाएगा? व्हाट विल द पिट्यूटरी प्रोड्यूस? कम ऑन, पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड विल प्रोड्यूस व्हाट? हाँ, करेक्ट. पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड विल प्रोड्यूस एफएसएच. एक्सीलेंट. सो सी माय डियर्स, आफ्टर 5 days ऑफ द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल, the hypothalamus synthesized GnRH. GnRH went to the pituitary gland. Now pituitary gland will produce FSH. Very nice. FSH will trigger the formation of which hormone? Excellent. Very good answer. Perfect answer. Perfect answer. Okay, good, good, very good. FSH will make which hormone? Not LH, my dear. FSH will trigger what? FSH क्या बनाएगा? कौन सा हार्मोन बनाएगा FSH? FSH कम हुआ तो LH बनेगा, बट FSH कौन से हार्मोन को बनाने में हेल्प करेगा? Yes, it's going to be the estrogen. So estrogen will be made by the cheeca interna, but under the influence of whom? FSH. So FSH is the one who will trigger the cheeca interna to make estrogen. ठीक है, जैसे कि तुम्हारे घर पे होता है नहीं होता है मुझे पता नहीं, मेरे घर पे ये बहुत होता है. हाँ मम्मा, आपने कितने दिन हो गए ये नहीं बनाया, मम्मा कितने दिन हो गए मैंने ये नहीं खाया है, मम्मा ये बनाओ ना, मम्मा ये बनाओ ना, आप बनाते ही नहीं हो, आप ये करते ही नहीं हो. हाँ, ये होता है कि नहीं होता है तुम्हारे घर पे? परेशान करते हो कि नहीं तुम्हारे मम्मा को ऐसे हर रोज ना? हाँ, तो मतलब कहानी कुछ अलग नहीं है मेरे घर की. बनाने वाला कौन है? बनाने वाली मैं हूँ, लेकिन मर्जी किसकी है? मर्जी, एग्जैक्टली, करेक्ट. सो हु इज गोइंग टू ट्रिगर मी टू मेक दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग? ऑफकोर्स माय सन, है ना? सो इट्स समथिंग लाइक दैट वे. ठीक है, इंटरना ईस्ट्रोजन बनाने वाला है, लेकिन उसको बनाने के लिए कंटिन्यूअसली इरिटेट कौन कर रहा है? FSH कर रहा है. हाँ, इरिटेटिंग ही होता है वो, एक बार दो बार चार बार कंटिन्यूअसली, कितना भी मम्मा ये बनाओ ना, मम्मा ये बनाओ ना, अरे अभी अभी तो खाया था, अरे हो गया ना उसके, चार दिन पहले खाया था, मम्मा बनाओ ना, चलता ही रहता है ये. हाँ, सिमिलर थिंग इज हैपनिंग ओवर हियर. फीका इंटरना फीका इंटरना जो है ना वो बनाता है, लेकिन कौन उसको इंस्टिगेट कर रहा है? किसके इन्फ्लुएंस के अंडर वो उसको बना रहा है? FSH के इन्फ्लुएंस के अंडर. डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस नाउ? सो हु इज गोइंग टू मेक ईस्ट्रोजन? फीका इंटरना. बट बिकॉज ऑफ हुम इट इज गोइंग टू मेक द ईस्ट्रोजन? FSH. Okay, yeah, now I think so you got it, what I'm trying to tell you. Good. somewhat relation actually वैसा नहीं है, but हाँ, somewhat the way you all irritate your mamas, same है. Oh, fine. So this is how the FSH is going to provoke the cheeca interna to make estrogen. Agreed? What is the second function of FSH? It converts what to what? Which follicle to which follicle? Come on. Tell me. एक function है estrogen को बनाने के लिए cheeca interna को परेशान करना. Very nice, Zoom. Very nice. और दूसरा काम क्या है? Excellent, Siddhika. Perfect answer, my dear. Very good. So it's going to be the ovarian follicle or the primary follicle to get converted into Krafft follicle. Correct? Very nice. So one more fill in the blank. The estrogen will reach its maximum potential on which day of the menstrual cycle? Nice. Tenth day पे extremes of estrogen हो जाएंगे. Tenth day, हाँ बेटा, not 14th day. Tenth day of the menstrual cycle, estrogen will reach the peak. On the 10th day, when the estrogen has reached the peak, it will go and tell whom to stop FSH production. Very nice. Exactly. Yes, Bhumi. Even I was thinking the same. Yes. Correct. The pituitary gland. Perfect. Now, the pituitary gland stops the formation of FSH. but the GnRH is still coming towards it, so it has to make some other hormone. What is the name of the other hormone? Very nice, very good, very good. Yes, so it's going to be the LH. Good. There is going to be an abrupt increase in the level of LH during 11th to the 13th day of the menstrual cycle, which is called as dash. Oh wow, very good, very good. All are giving me right answer. Very nice, my dear. Bilkul sahi, bilkul sahi. Correct, correct. It's called as LH surge. This LH surge is going to cause the rupturing of dash. Very nice. All are correct. Very good, my dear. Hey, endometrium, jisse likha hai, wo wrong hai. It doesn't rupture the endometrium. Who's that? He's not. It's not endometrium ka rupturing. It's Graafian follicle ka rupturing. Right. So it's going to rupture the Graafian follicle. Now, what will happen? Once the Graafian follicle is going to be ruptured, the secondary oocyte and the first polar body will be thrown out into the fallopian tube. This process is called as dash. Very nice. Yes, correct, correct. Very, very. Yes, right. So this process is going to be called as ovulation. Normally, ovulation takes place on the dash day of the menstrual cycle. Oh, wow. So nice. Perfect answer. Very nice. Very nice. So I guess, अब तक जितना मैंने तुम्हें पढ़ाया है सब आपको समझ में आ गया बेटा. बोलो फिर और ओके विद दिस. I know. You, this is the way, you know, like when I take the fill in the blanks for such type of topics now, then it will become, you know, very clear also. And if you are, you know, mistaken somewhere now, you will get yourself rectified also. You will come to know that, oh, my thinking was this, but it is this. Ovulation takes place right in the middle. Yes, but yes, I know. Okay, so I hope you all have understood up till now. Move my water. Fine. Ab 28 days ka menstrual cycle bataya gaya hai. 28 days mein se 14 days kya hota hai, wo humne already dekh liya. Jo sabse important tha. I'll tell you the function, my dear. First function of estrogen is to control the formation of FSH. That is the first function. And I'll tell you what will happen then in the next 14 days. Now this ovulation has occurred. Yes, Divya. Yes, Divya. Divya, you are right. Half of the menstrual cycle is going to be now 50% done. Then we come to the post-ovulatory phase, means what will happen once the secondary oocyte is into the fallopian tube. Right? After ovulation, the ruptured Graafian follicle transforms into corpus luteum. You already know this, correct? The granulosa and the theca cells of the ruptured Graafian follicle, which is now called as corpus luteum, is found only in mammals and contains a yellow lutein or carotene pigment. In case of absence of pregnancy, this corpus luteum will get degenerated after 14 days of its formation. The degenerated corpus luteum is going to be called as corpus albicans, that is nothing but white body, which we have actually done earlier. So technically, post-ovulatory phase mein kuch nahi ho raha hai. 9 days tak wo wait karta hai, matlab 14 plus 9 days. So 23 days tak. Overall, matlab hum log dekhe, to on the 23rd day of the menstrual cycle, the corpus luteum will start to degenerate It will take 5 more days to completely regenerate and become corpus albicans. Simple, easy. Now see what happens if fertilization takes place. Function of the corpus luteum, which we have already seen actually, stimulated by the rising levels of LH, corpus luteum secretes progesterone hormone. Now this is the most important sentence, that stimulated by the rising levels of LH, corpus luteum secretes progesterone hormone. So jaise estrogen banane ke liye interna cells the, lekin unko pareshan karne wala FSH tha, right? Waise hi progesterone banane wala jo hai wo corpus luteum hai, lekin usko pareshan karne wala LH hai. So LH ke influence ke under this particular corpus luteum is going to synthesize progesterone. Yes, actually it will wait in the sense it will remain stable for the first 9 days, and then last 5 days it will start getting degenerated, chotu, okay, chota white color ka ek wrinkled scar banke chala jayega. Fine. So the LH surge is causing two things to happen. First is bursting of the Graafian follicle, and second thing is to start making progesterone. These two are because of the LH. Okay, the progesterone facilitates the preparation. Now here comes the most important point. The progesterone facilitates the preparation of endometrium for receiving the embryo and its implantation. So as and when the secondary follicle is out into the fallopian tube, immediately the progesterone that is going to be formed by the corpus luteum will take care of making a cushion for the embryo. Cushion matlab kya? Endometrium ka jo wall hai, usko thick banane ka kaam progesterone chalu karta hai. 9 din tak lagatar ye jo progesterone hai, ye kya karta hai? 9 days, matlab jab tak corpus albicans स्टेबल है तब तक कॉर्पस एल्बिकन्स प्रोजेस्टेरोन सिंथेसाइज करता जाएगा, एंड मोर वुड बी द प्रोजेस्टेरोन फॉर्मेशन, बेटर वुड बी द एंडोमेट्रियम का वॉल रिपेयर एंड थिकनिंग. ओके, देयर विल बी थिकनिंग ऑफ द एंडोमेट्रियम. ओके, प्रोजेस्टेरोन ऑल्सो इनहिबिट्स, मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है बेटा ये सारे, मतलब of course from your exam point of view yes they are very important, but even from your future study point of view they are very important. See, progesterone inhibits the contraction of uterus so that the pregnancy could be maintained. So we know endometrium ke bahar ke taraf hai muscularis. You remember muscularis layer is going to be present sandwiched between endometrium and perimetrium, hai na? So this is a muscular layer. So muscles have a habit of contracting, right? Now to prevent this contracting, because if they contract, itna mehnat kiya hai wo endometrium banane ka, contract ho gaya to pura squeeze ho gaya to endometrium khatam, correct? So progesterone is also going to prevent what? It's also going to prevent contraction of uterus wall. So the muscularis will not be functional. Till what time? Till the time progesterone is there. And therefore, do you remember? Progesterone is going to be produced for all the 9 months, is what I had told you all. So during all the 9 months of the pregnancy, muscularis should not contract, muscles should not contract. Only then it is not going to harm the baby. Right? Understood? So instead of such a process, if the unused egg could degenerate, then woman would not have to. It cannot degenerate on its own, na beta. Hormonal based, then a wo. Correct? Yeah, I'll tell you what is corona radiata ka function. I'll tell you. Okay, so you understood up till here. So progesterone is going to inhibit the contraction of uterus so that the pregnancy could be maintained. Progesterone also inhibits the development of next new ovarian follicle, and that is the reason once a female is detected of pregnancy, she will never experience menstrual cycle till she gives birth to the her child. And even there's going to be something called as lactational amenorrhea, that is still she is breastfeeding the child, generally she will not experience any menstrual cycles. This is what is called as lactational amenorrhea. Aage bataungi uske bare mein. I'm going to talk about that also. So what is happening, see, though the ovarian follicles are there, they won't become Graafian follicles. Once pregnancy is detected, okay, or once fertilization has occurred. So what is the topic? If fertilization takes place, then they are saying that progesterone inhibits the development of next new ovarian follicle. That is what lactational amenorrhea and its hormones ke bare mein I'll tell you all later. Okay. If pregnancy occurs, then the corpus luteum persists for all the 9 months and synthesizes progesterone. Progesterone is important to maintain the pregnancy and is thus called as pregnancy hormone. Right? What's your doubt, my dear? That if the level of progesterone does not stay stable, then there is a chance of muscles contraction. Yeah, that is what is called as miscarriages then. Okay? That is also one of the reasons for miscarriage. Some of the females have got the problem of recurrent miscarriages. So even this is one of the reasons. One of them, not the only reason. There are many reasons, but this is one of the reasons. Okay? Well, by the 4th month of pregnancy, the placenta has developed completely. So placenta is going to be a tissue which is going to provide nourishment to the developing embryo. So they are saying because of this progesterone, by the 4th month of pregnancy, placenta development is going to be completed. Now, what is going to happen? See, now this placenta will take up the job of progesterone secretion in more amount. Okay, so it takes over the job of further progesterone secretion. Ovary also secretes some amount of relaxin at the time of parturition. Parturition means childbirth. So at the time of childbirth, the ovary is also going to secrete one more hormone, that is relaxin. So what is the role of relaxin during the 3rd part of this chapter? What happens in miscarriage? Miscarriage may the fetus development will not take place. Embryo implantation is not rightly done. So the female will experience menstrual cycle. Okay, that is called as miscarriages. So this is the function of the progesterone if this is going to take place. What fertilization is going to take place. Any doubts, any confusion over here? Any difficulty, my dears? Kya kya role hai progesterone ka? If fertilization take place, samajh mein aaya? Miscarriages can happen at any time, my dear. It's not like, yeah, it will be washed out. Yes, fertilized egg is going to get washed out, slogged out. Correct. Okay. We cannot fall in the 4th month. We will not call it as a miscarriage. It's called as a premature delivery. Because by the 4th month of the pregnancy, the fetus is completely ready in a miniature form. Chote hote hai, but completely ready. Okay. What happens in miscarriage? I told you what happens in miscarriage. It's going to be the fetus is not going to remain inside the mother's womb. That underdeveloped condition may it is going to be washed away, it's going to be thrown away out of the mother's flow, the menstrual flow. we generally call it as a, yeah, they won't survive. See, like just few days before only, one of my cousin sister's daughter, she delivered, you know, twins, which were premature. So she delivered in the 5th month of her pregnancy. So that one of the twins, may say one of the child could not survive. The other is surviving, though struggling, but still surviving. So it's a premature delivery. Sometimes premature deliveries are successful also. It's not necessary that always it's going to be, you know, death. But yeah, one of the children, may say eight, jo thi wo, one child died. Now let's see what will happen if fertilization does not take place. Majority of the time, this is the thing that's going to happen. If pregnancy does not occur after ovulation, then as the progesterone level rises, okay, what will happen? Its rising level inhibits the release of GnRH from hypothalamus. So now the progesterone is going to be synthesized and now it will reach its peak. And it's not being utilized, right? It has done the job, but it is not being utilized. So what will happen? It will send a negative feedback to the hypothalamus. So see, their testosterone was sending a negative feedback to the hypothalamus. Here it is progesterone, which is sending a negative feedback to the hypothalamus, inhibit the release of GnRH. Okay, got it? Due to this, FSH, LH secretion by the pituitary falls down. GnRH was the main one who was, you know, instigating the pituitary gland. Chalo, FSH banao, FSH banao. Estrogen ne aake bola mat banao. To FSH nahi banaya, to LH banaya tha. Ab LH banaya, to LH ki influence mein progesterone bana. Now the progesterone is going to tell the hypothalamus, don't make enough. Right? So now GnRH नहीं form होगा. So if no GnRH formation, automatically FSH and LH will be not made. So this will decrease the level of FSH and LH. Okay. So due to this FSH, everyone is influencing each other. Yes. Due to this FSH, LH secretion by pituitary falls. And thereby, progesterone secretion by the corpus luteum also now falls, which was due to the influence of LH, right? As the progesterone level drops, the corpus luteum begins to degenerate and transform into corpus albicans. Once it is corpus albicans, it cannot secrete progesterone. Okay, na? Yahan tak samjha kya hua? Right? Now see. What will happen now if the progesterone is not going to be made? Progesterone jitna bana hai, utna bana hai. Ab wo nahi zyada nahi abhi banana hai usko. So what will happen? The overgrown endometrium, see, already progesterone ne matlab anticipate kiya tha ki fertilization hoga. So in that anticipation, the progesterone had made the cushion. That means the progesterone had increased the thickness of the endometrium, correct? But now what will happen? No more progesterone is being formed. So the overgrown endometrium now begin to break and start to separate from the inner uterine wall, that is the endometrium, of course, and will start causing bleeding. So 9 + 5, 14 days, okay, beta? So after 14 days, what will happen? Complete stopping of the progesterone. So now the endometrium wall is starting to break and get slogged off. The uterine contraction, which is still now inhibited due to the presence of progesterone, will start. So now the muscularis will start contracting. Why? Progesterone ka influence chala gaya. Progesterone ab hai nahi uske upar dadagiri karne ke liye. So, uski marzi ab. So now the muscularis will start undergoing contraction. Thus, the separated endometrium along with blood is now being passed out via the vaginal route. This is again the beginning of the next menstrual cycle or the bleeding phase. So what causes pain, you all understood? My dear girls, I know some of us do have a very bad phase, you know, when we are experiencing this menstrual cycle. It's basically this contraction of the muscles, which is actually squeezing the endometrium, and the endometrium is getting scraped off. Okay. What will happen if the fertilization takes place with the corpus luteum will not be formed only, na? For all the 9 months, it's going to be the corpus luteum only intact, stable. Albicans banega hi nahi agar fertilization hota hai. If there is no fertilization, only then albicans will be formed. Then why do, it's complete muscular pain rivet actually. Like all the muscles of our body, na, they are extensive muscular contractions is going to cause all the muscles to get involved somewhere or the other. Okay. Fertilization cannot happen on the 9th day at all, because the life of the egg is only 24 hours to 48 hours after ovulation. So maximum by 15th or 16th day of the menstrual cycle, if it is not fertilized, gone. Uterine wall must be contracting for the whole five. No. It is like, you know, the intensity of contraction will be maximum on the first day, first and second day, maximum. And once like it has squeezed off now, so even if now see, it was very tight now. That endometrium had become very thick. It has become very tight. So to squeeze tighter, it requires all the more impulsive actions. Now, as majority of it is going to be slogged off, then it's going to be a bit okay types. Right? Got it? Yes. A few of you all had asked something which I missed because there were many questions which were coming. So if I haven't answered your query, can you please repost your query, cut out. I mean, I might have missed one or two is what I felt, because by the time I was reading, ek do upar chale gaye. Where does the blood come from? You saw just now corpus hemorrhagicum, that was that red color ka blood spot in the corpus albicans, in the corpus luteum, which is going to be supplemented with the blood capillaries. It's going to come from there. So this is the total of 28 days, my dear. From 23 day to the 28th day, corpus albicans is going to be, you know, on its way to be formed. And it will take on the 20th day generally, corpus albicans has completely been formed and this cycle will begin. Okay. So this cycle is exactly of 28 days. Ideally, again, I'm saying. Okay, ideally. Got it? Any doubts? Any difficulties? Any issues? Sure, na? Huh. Yes. Correct. Yes, Divya. Right, my dear. You're right. Well, so this is how it's being given in the diagrammatic form. If you can see here, we'll first talk about the endometrium. There are many reasons for premature birth, not one or two, there are many. It depends on the blood pressure. It depends if the mother is having diabetes. It depends on the mental stress. It depends on the health of the baby also sometimes. There are many reasons. The diagram is the same. This is the endometrium. So here they are saying this is the menstrual phase, which is generally going to be 1 to 5 days as we know. So see, it's getting scraped off. Okay. Then it is again going to be built up under the influence of progesterone. So So here you can see the progesterone is highest. Here you can see very well, the progesterone is highest. When there is highest amount of progesterone, it's going to be the highest amount of endometrium formation. When the progesterone level drops down, again, there is going to be the scraping of the endometrial wall. This is the ovarian hormone. So estrogen is going to be maximum on the 10th day, which will cause ovulation on the 14th day. So this is the middle of the cycle where ovulation is taking place. This is the anterior pituitary hormone. So here you can see this is the FSH. FSH on the 10th day is maximum. Correct? It's going to be maximum. Right? Follicle burst, the estrogen and progesterone also released. Progesterone and estrogen ka release. Matlab it's going to be released along with it, of course. Yes. Okay. So look at this. This is the LH surge. LH surge is going to be there on the 11th to the 13th day, which will cause the rupturing or the ovulation or the, bursting of the Graafian follicle seed. Right? So here is going to be the release of the Graafian follicle. Right? Then you can see FSH level goes down. FSH level is going to go down still further. And even LH level is going to go down. If LH level is going to go down, see what is going to happen now. Corpus luteum formation is taking place. It's going to wait. This is the 23rd day. It's going to wait for the fertilization to occur. Then it will get reduced to form corpus albicans. Here they're talking about the body temperature. Generally, on the day of ovulation, our body temperature is going to be a bit higher, 36 degree and 37 degree Celsius. 1 degree ka farak hai. Bukhar nahi aata hai. Thoda sa temperature agar measure karte hai, to thoda sa yahan par ye ovulation day se corpus albicans banne tak ke jo 14 days hai, it's going to be a bit of higher temperature is what has been proved. So you all have understood everything about how this exactly menstrual cycle is going to be carried out. A hormonal discharges, beta. It's because of the hormonal discharges, na? The body temperature varies a little, not much, a little. Okay. Yeah, this is one of the most favorite questions of your board examiners also. So this might be asked in your board examinations as well. Total loss of blood per day is about 20 ml. So on an average, 40 to 80 ml of the blood is lost per cycle. This blood cannot clot. It does not have the clotting factors. So menstrual blood will never clot. The period between ovulation and next menstrual bleeding is always constant, means 14 days. However, the ovulation date may vary, causing a change in pre-ovulatory period. So instead of 14th day, if the a discharge of the secondary oocyte is going to be on the 16th day, then 16 plus 14. Then the bleeding phase will be also experienced on the 30th day. Understood? So that's why I said that this cycle may vary. So it depends on the ovulation. If the ovulation is going to be on the 12th day, then the next menstrual cycle will be experienced 12 plus 14. So it will be on the 26th day. Okay, so it depends on what day the ovulation has taken place. That may vary. But once the ovulation has taken place, exactly after 14 days, the menstrual cycle is going to be expected again. But we don't come to know that when this ovulation has taken place actually. Right? After ovulation, the ovum is viable for only 2 days, 24 to 48 hours maximum. While the sperms introduced into the vagina can survive for maximum 4 days, 3 to 4 days. On the basis of the above data, the safe period method for family planning can be calculated. So suppose a couple does not want to have children, then they can calculate this particular timing and they can have, a predetermined mindset that when they are ready for becoming parents. normally it is considered to be 1 to 8 days wherein definitely ovulation will not take place. So there is no chance of having children. And generally from the 20th to the 28th day, because corpus luteum has started to degenerate and the life of the egg is only 2 days. So 14th day pe agar egg ovulation hota hai, chalo 15th pe hoga, 16th pe hoga, maximum 17th, 18th pe hoga, to 20th day tak to wo survive nahi kar paata hai. So that is how you know it's calculated, but it is not foolproof. It's not a foolproof method because we can't say in some females there is delayed ovulation. In that case, this method cannot be adopted. Okay. So what is the life of the ova, beta? What is the life of the secondary oocyte? Only 2 days. And what is the life of the spermatozoa? Only 4 days. But फिर भी 4 days double than the life of ova. Well, so this is how the diagram that we studied the same way. Hypothalamus produces GnRH. GnRH will trigger the pituitary to make LH or FSH. It will reach the ovary. Ovary will produce estrogen and progesterone, which are going to be a part of the uterus. Positive feedback given by estrogen from 12 to 14 days तक ये चलता रहेगा सिलसिला, okay? Then over most of the cycle, the negative feedback is going to be there whenever the days that we have studied. Same. Look at this. Even this is the same thing, but the diagram they have given you. That's it. Otherwise, nothing else. A. Can you see this A? GnRH produces anterior lobe cells to secrete FSH and LH. This is A. B, FSH and LH promote follicle growth and oocyte maturation, estrogen production, priming of endometrium. Priming of endometrium means making layers of endometrium. Other reproductive events. C, blood level of estrogen rises. It will stimulate the surge in LH secretion. Okay. This is your C. D, mid-cycle surge of LH triggers ovulation, then formation of corpus luteum. Progesterone, estrogen secreted by corpus luteum will maintain the endometrium if pregnancy occurs. F, the rise in progesterone, estrogen in blood will inhibit FSH and LH during the last phase of the cycle, sending a negative feedback and stopping the production of GnRH. So same thing that we have done, same they have given it in a diagrammatic. That's it. Okay. The last, that will come under the next chapter, beta, reproductive health. Okay. The last to complete the second part of this reproduction in humans is the next organ, that is the breasts. They also serve as axillary reproductive organs in women. Human female possesses a pair of breasts containing mammary glands. These are situated in the front of the thorax on the pectoral muscles. So the chest muscles are going to be called as pectoral muscles. Okay. Each mammary gland has 15 to 20 tubulo-alveolar lobules contained in its connective tissue. So if you look at this diagram, see, you can see this, that these are the lobes. Can you see? Lobe containing alveoli. Okay, so these are the lobes. The space between the lobules is filled with fatty acids, fatty tissues. The lobules contain milk glands in the form of bunches of grapes, which secretes milk. Numerous small ductules arise from each lobule, combined to form lactiferous duct. You can see over here the lactiferous duct. Here, can you see this? So these lobules combine to form these lactiferous duct. So this is the lobule containing alveoli. The lobules combine like this way, and they form the lactiferous duct. Clear? how the lactiferous duct is going to be there. Now see what happens. Such lactiferous ducts open independently in the area called as the nipple. So the projection over here is going to be the nipple. So you can see all these ducts are merging together and they are going to be collected in a particular area, which will be called as the nipple. A nipple is pigmented structure, which is elevated knob-like at the apical part of the mammary gland. The area adjacent to the nipple is deeply pigmented, which is known as areola mammae. Jo hai na, that is a darkly pigmented area that is going to be seen. We know that the breasts are going to be rudimentary in case of males, but the nipple and the areola mammae will also be seen in males as well. Okay, though it's rudimentary. That is the reason for it, Palak. See, the area surrounding the nipple becomes much elevated because of the accumulation of fat and by the presence of muscle, which is going to be densely pigmented. It is provided with 15 to 20 small pores of 0.5 mm size. In men, the nipples are rudimentary or vestigial. Vestigial means practically of no use. In females, it's going to be helping in feeding the child. Mammary glands produce a nutritive fluid, milk, for the nourishment of young ones. Milk protects the young ones from various infections up to some months after the birth. It's very important. Breastfeeding is very important. For development of breasts, four hormones work together. Estrogen for the growth of tubules of the breast glands. Progesterone for the growth of the follicles of the breast glands. Prolactin, milk synthesizing hormone in breast glands, and oxytocin help in milk ejection. So I have very clearly mentioned the role of each and every hormone. These things are not there in your books. Huh? In books, now they have just made that it's made up of what, and in the exams they ask you match the following, or they ask you select the incorrect pair among the following, and so on. So be very careful for each of them. Estrogen, tubules. Progesterone, follicles, prolactin, milk synthesis, and oxytocin, milk ejection. Okay? Yes, they do ask. So this is going to be the fat tissue wherever there is going to be space. This is the fat tissue. This is the lobule containing the alveoli. Here is the areola, which is areola mammae, which is going to be the darkly pigmented area. Opening of the lactiferous duct, lactiferous sinuses. Sinuses means pores, openings. Fine. And this is going to be the pectoral muscle. This is a muscle on which the breasts are going to be, taking the support of. Ejection of the milk is going to be, only after the first suckling action of the baby. Unless and until the baby does not start the suckling action, the oxytocin won't be released from the pituitary gland of the mother. So the suckling action of the baby is the one who will send a signal for making the oxytocin, and oxytocin will then liberate the milk into the mouth of the young baby. Okay. It storing is going to be there temporary in these areas, lobules, but it needs to be sucked by the newborn baby. Fine. Well, that's the end of the second part. That is the female reproductive structure is also done entirely. And in the next class, we'll be going ahead with the third and the concluding part of this chapter. That is going to be fertilization and post-fertilization events. 12th HSC book, okay, I'll share it. Yeah, it's going to be, yes, they already know, this is going to be, this will come in your neural control, that there are certain actions which are inherent. Okay. Oxytocin produced only during pregnancy. Yes. Reproductive health is a new chapter, my dear. reproductive health does not come under this chapter. This chapter is only with completion. Now we have completed 70% of the chapter. Now only 30% is remaining, that is fertilization and post-fertilization needs. Okay, fine, my dears. Thank you for waiting a bit extra, but I wanted to complete this today. Thank you so much. Bye, see you all. Have a nice weekend ahead, and let's complete, try to make up with the new part of this chapter, that is going to be what will happen once the fertilization takes place and how does it happen. Okay, bye bye. See you all. Yeah, bye bye.